Okay, so today we are going to see how to create the glass material in Vray in 3ds Max. This is we are using the Vray 5, but we can apply this setting to any version of Vray 5, including Vray 6 also. So what we have to do, we will create the many type of glass, including the clear glass, tinted glass, bump glass, and how to create them and what is the value we will create when we will see step by step. So first we are going to create the first glass, which is clear glass. So first we will open our slot. We will get material and we will select the our material, which is Vray MTL, which is Vray material. After that, for clear glass, we need to just three value. We will first set the diffuse color, which is the dark gray of value 5. We will need a reflect color, which is at a value of 230. And we will need a refract color, which is of value of 250. We will first click on diffuse. We set the value to be 5. That reflect value, we will set it value to be 230. And refract, we will use the value of 240. And that's how we create our first glass, which is clear glass. We will now go to apply to our scene. And let us see in the rendering how it's appear. As you can see, this is our teapot, which is the this shape, and this is our glass. As you can see that it's a pure clear glass, and we can see that the lining, this represents the glass. So that's, you can see the first glass, which is the clear glass. Now the second glass, we will use tinted glass. So how to make it? We will first copy this clear glass to another slot, because some setting like reflect and refract will be same as that of clear glass. We will rename it and then we will use the following setting to make our tinted glass. So first we will set the diffuse color to be red 7, green to be 8, blue to be 8. After that we will go to the fog color and we will set the red color to be the value of 214, green color to be of value of 254, blue color to be of value of 254. Click OK. The other thing, like reflect and refract, to be have the same value, means reflect, we will set the value to 240, and reflect, we will set it to value of 230. Now this is our tinted glass. Now we will just drag and drop and apply it to this setting. And now we will see how it will look by rendering it. So this is our tinted glass. As you can see, it's very little, like a greenish color, and it's a tint value like this one. We can make this tinted glass to be of various color also, to give it a very beautiful look like that of a window light. So how we can give this? We just have to change the fog color of every glass to give it various colorful glass. So now we will just copy our previously created tinted material to various copy, and we will just change the fog color to make it different tinted color glass. So we'll just copy here. We'll just name it red. We will give it red color. We'll go to the fog color. And now we will just set it to something like red color. And then here also, we will set it to something like red color. By doing so, we will just created our red tinted glass. We'll just copy here also. And now just make something like yellow color. We'll just set it to yellow color. Now just go to the fog color and here also set our yellow color. Just copy here and we will just make a blue color. So we will just go to the diffuse. Just make sure to rename, otherwise the original material will also change. Go to blue, we will set it to blue color, and then fog color also, we will set it to something like blue. Now we will make our orange tinted glass. We will set it to something like orange color, and it's fog color to be like something orange color. Now we will just apply it to one by one. We will apply here. So here with all the color, we will just now render it of all the tinted glass into one. So another glass we are going to make is the frosted glass. So for frosted glass, we will just copy this tinted glass and we will rename this . After that, we will just go to the maps, and here we will just go to the bump map, click on no map, and then we will select the noise. After that, we will set the size of noise to be approximately 0.4, and we will set the go to parent. And then we will set the bump value to be approximately 5%. You can increase the bump. The more you will increase the bump, the more it will be frost. Just click on render. So as you can see, this is our frosted glass. The region which is behind the frosted glass, as you can see, it's a blurry image. Like, you can use this type of glass in case of like window or a bathroom case. And this region which is not in place of glass will be perfectly clear. So this is our frosted glass. So let's move to our final glass, which is our textured glass. For textured glass, we will need a black and white image of any texture. You can download it by googling it. Try to take the black and white image, because this will only give the depth to that glass. So we'll be using any black and white image like this one. Make sure it will be JPG image or PNG for file format. Now for texture glass, we will first copy our clear glass. After that, we will just go to the map. In a map, just go to the bump map. Here we will use the bitmap, and the bitmap, we will use our black and white image. Make sure to set the turn off real world scale, and tiling should be 1:1. Double click on it to see the effect. So as we can see, now we have the floral texture to be as a bump or giving the depth effect. Make sure that you will be able to apply the UVW map, otherwise flora will not be visible. As you can see, it is not visible perfectly. So first we will apply the UVW map to it. Here we will use the mapping as a box mapping and uncheck the real world scale. And now I'm trying to just remove that vector images which is shown. We just scale this and render this. So this is our texture glass. As you can see, the texture of black and white image is visually appeared on the glass surface. We can also use any type of image. You can also use the picture of any person also in place of that texture.